He and one of his brothers went to Australia and Ballarat to the gold fields. He was one of lots of people who went to Australia to seek their fortune. But it doesn't matter what nationality or where they were from, everyone was treated equally. 'Cause most people didn't have that much money, and that's why they went to the gold fields. But there was a big corruption with all the leaders, the government, and everyone, because not many people were paying for the gold licenses. Each month, the miners had to pay 30 shillings every time they wanted to mine. But even if they paid but left their licenses at home, they either couldn't mine or had to go to jail. And if you weren't a leader, you weren't allowed to vote. He fought for fair conditions and miners allowed to vote. The only bad thing about what Layla did was that he actually encouraged all the miners to fight back and use violence. And that wasn't good. That started the whole battle. They built a stockade to protect all their weapons, and they burned all the licenses for a threat. After putting up the flag, they all circled around the flag and did the digger's oath. And they said that they would all stay together no matter what. At dawn on the 3rd of December, the police troops attacked. They formed a battle, and 30 miners died and 4 soldiers died. But sadly, Layla got his arm wounded and he had to get it amputated. When Peter was hurt, a priest hit him to let him recover. Then the government set out a reward to find him. After everything had ended, Peter was voted to become one of the people in the parliament until he died at the age of 62. I'm glad to say that Peter Layla was one of Australia's most important historical figures. That's why people call him the father of democracy.